In transient conduction, it is often important to calculate the total energy transfer during a certain time. So in order to do so, we need to start with the simplified overall energy balance such that E in minus E out is equal to the change in the stored energy. Depending on whether energy is being put in or taken out, either E in or E out drops out. So here we're going to assume that energy is transferred out of the system, which means that E in is going to be equal to zero. So our Q is going to be equal to our minus E out. And the way to look at that then is that Q equals minus the energy at some time minus the energy at T equals zero. So we can rewrite this as Q is equal to minus rho density times the heat capacity times RT, whatever T we're looking at, some X and some T, and I'm calculating this currently for a plane wall with convection, minus T sub I dV, where this is integrated over the volume of the wall. So we now normalize this Q by introducing Q sub zero, which is that rho times the C times the volume times Ti minus T infinity. And so this Q zero is considered the maximum amount of energy transfer that could occur. One way to look at it is that Ti minus T infinity is the largest possible change in temperature that we could get. So now let's write the whole thing out. So Q divided by Q zero is equal to the integral of minus T of XT minus Ti divided by now Ti minus T infinity dV over the volume. And we're going to assume that that volume is constant. And we can rewrite this as pull out that 1 over V, the integral over the total volume, 1 minus theta star dV. And by definition, this theta star is equal to T minus T infinity divided by Ti minus T infinity. And this can also be rewritten as this theta star sub zero, which is the center line temperature, times the cosine of our eigenvalue times X star, where X star is the normalized length into the wall. So if we integrate this, we're left with that Q over Q zero is equal to 1 minus, now we have the sine of our eigenvalue divided by the eigenvalue itself, times theta star sub zero. So our theta star, and again, this is the considered the mid-plane temperature, is equal to C1 exponential minus this eigenvalue squared times the Fourier number. So the total energy transfer for a long cylinder or sphere is done the exact same way. We do use the same normalization term, Q0, but remember that volume is going to change. So for a cylinder, we write it as theta star is equal now to this theta zero star times the Bessel function of the first kind of this eigenvalue times R star, where R star is that dimensionless radius. And then our sphere, theta star, is equal to theta zero star, 1 over our eigenvalue times R star, and then the sine of our eigenvalue times our R star. Again, our theta zero is as shown above. So the integrations produce the following expressions for these geometries. So the first one is our cylinder. Q over Q zero is equal to 1 minus 2 times this theta zero star divided by the eigenvalue times the Bessel function again of the first kind of the eigenvalue. And a sphere, we get the ratio of our Q divided by Q zero is equal to a slightly more complex 1 minus 3 times this theta zero star divided by, and now we have a cube term here of the eigenvalue, and this whole thing is multiplied by the sine of the eigenvalue 1 minus the eigenvalue times the cosine again of that eigenvalue. So as a reminder, the eigenvalues are obtained through a one-term approximation of an infinite series solution, and these Bessel functions are, again, Bessel functions of the first kind that can be calculated or looked up in the appropriate table. So to find the total energy transferred during a certain time, you need to calculate the normalized energy transfer and then multiply it by Q zero. The way to look at it is that your original solution shows you the fraction of the maximum energy transfer. And that's what would occur as time approaches infinity. So in future screencasts, we'll show you how to use these equations and find the total energy transfer for different geometries.